Hello students, welcome to all these color classes. So today I will be taking chapter 15 from class 8 science, part 3, some natural phenomena. So we have already discussed a lot in the part 1 and part 2, what are the natural phenomena. And today we will start with one of the natural phenomena, that is lightning. Okay, and we will see its effect. How the story of a lightning, how lightning takes place, and all today we will be discussing in today's lecture. Okay, so the first question is what is lightning? You must be aware of lightning. आपने देखा होगा बिजली चमकती है. Lightning is there, thunder is strong, some sounds are there. Okay, so what basically is that? So that lightning is the discharge of electric charge. If you will go in the part 2 video, I have discussed all about charges. Okay, so first please refer part 2 so that lightning can be very clear to you. आप जब part 2 का video देखोगे, तो उसमें charges के बारे में सारा discussion है. आप एक बार उसको देख लोगे, तो lightning आपके लिए बहुत easy हो जाएगा समझना. Okay, so lightning क्या है? एक electric discharge है. Or you can say an electric spark. You must have seen that when lightning takes place, there is a sparking. Okay? So, it occurs in our nature. We see that in the clouds, in our sky, it occurs. And it occurs in a major scale. Okay? So, you can say that lightning is an electric discharge or an electric spark that occurs in our nature on a larger scale. Fine? So how basically lightning is caused? If somebody asks you okay, what is the cause of lightning? So there is a simple cause that there is an accumulation of charges. जो charges हैं वो accumulate हो जाते हैं, वो एक जगह collect हो जाते हैं, जिसकी वजह से lightning होती है, bright lights होती है, bright streaks of lights हैं, sound produce होता है. That is because of that. Okay? So first we will see the definition of lightning. So lightning is an electric discharge. Okay? Or electric spark in nature. In nature on larger scale. Fine? So lightning is an electric discharge or electric spark in nature on larger scale. Secondly, how it is being caused? It is caused by the accumulation of charges which produces sound and spark. Okay, sparking of lights are there, spark of light, and sound is being produced. So lightning is an electric discharge or electric spark in nature on large scale. It is caused by the accumulation of charges. The charges get collected. I will be telling you the whole story of lightning. Then you will get to know that how positive, negative charge they get collected. Okay? Which produces the sound and the spark of light. So this was just a definition of lightning. We will see the story of lightning, or you can say we will see that how this electric discharge takes place. Agar lightning electric discharge hai, to ye electric discharge basically hota kaise hai? Ye jo lightning ki story hai, ye kaise hoti hai? Kya procedure hai uska? We will see that number one. Okay? So this was ओके सो स्टोरी ऑफ लाइटनिंग मतलब कि हमें क्या जानना है, इलेक्ट्रिक डिस्चार्ज अगर लाइटनिंग है तो ये इलेक्ट्रिक डिस्चार्ज होता कैसे, वी विल सी इन अ फ्लो डायग्राम। नाउ व्हाट हैपेंस, सबसे पहले क्या होगा, देयर इज अ थंडर स्टॉर्म, थंडर स्टॉर्म टेक्स प्लेस। सो व्हेन थंडर स्टॉर्म टेक्स प्लेस द हॉट एयर करंट दैट इज प्रेजेंट इन आवर नेचर इट मूव्स अपवर्ड। हॉट एयर जो है वो कहां जाएगी, वो मूव करेगी अपवर्ड। ओके और जब हॉट एयर अपवर्ड मूव करेगी तो क्या होगा, वाटर ड्रॉपलेट्स आएंगे डाउनवर्ड की तरफ। ओके सो सबसे पहली चीज क्या होगी, हॉट एयर मूव्स अपवर्ड, हॉट एयर कहां जाएगी, ऐसे ऊपर की तरफ मूव करेगी। जब हॉट एयर मूव करेगी ऊपर तो क्या होगा, वाटर ड्रॉपलेट्स, चूंकि एयर हॉट है तो उससे क्या निकलेगी, ड्रॉपलेट्स निकलेंगे। आपने देखा होगा जब घर में भी आपके वेपर बनता है, आप प्लेट को ढक दीजिए, सॉरी किसी बर्तन को ढक दीजिए जिसमें कि पानी उबल रहा है, बॉइल हो रहा है, तो क्या होगा, ड्रॉपलेट्स बनेंगे वेपर की वजह से। तो सेम इज इन दिस केस, जब हॉट एयर मूव्स अपवर्ड, हॉट एयर करंट मूव्स अपवर्ड, व्हाट इज गोइंग टू हैपन, वाटर ड्रॉपलेट्स दे विल मूव डाउन, वाटर ड्रॉपलेट्स मूव्स डाउनवर्ड। ओके वाटर ड्रॉपलेट्स नीचे की तरफ आएंगे। नाउ बिकॉज ऑफ दिस दैट हॉट एयर इज मूविंग अपवर्ड, वाटर ड्रॉपलेट्स मूव्स डाउनवर्ड, दिस इज गोइंग टू कॉज अ सेपरेशन ऑफ चार्जेस बिटवीन टू क्लाउड्स, दो क्लाउड के बीच में एक सेपरेशन होगा चार्जेस का, एंड ऑल्सो बिटवीन द क्लाउड एंड द अर्थ। ओके सो दिस विल कॉज सेपरेशन ऑफ चार्जेस। ओके अब ये जो सेपरेशन होगा चार्जेस का, ये किसके किसके बीच में होगा, सेपरेशन ऑफ चार्जेस दो तरीके से होंगे, एक तो क्या होगा कि क्लाउड्स के बीच में सेपरेशन होगा, बिटवीन द क्लाउड्स, ओके बिटवीन द क्लाउड्स सेपरेशन होंगे चार्जेस के, सपोज दिस इज वन क्लाउड एंड दिस इज द अदर क्लाउड, इन दोनों के बीच में चार्जेस का सेपरेशन हो जाएगा। दूसरी चीज क्या होगी, बिटवीन द क्लाउड एंड अर्थ, अर्थ और क्लाउड के बीच में सेपरेशन हो जाएगा चार्ज का। ओके सो वाटर ड्रॉपलेट्स जो डाउनवर्ड आएंगे और हॉट एयर अपवर्ड जाती है उसकी वजह से क्या हो रहा है, सेपरेशन हो रहा है ऑफ चार्जेस बिटवीन द क्लाउड्स एंड बिटवीन द क्लाउड एंड द अर्थ। राइट यहां तक क्लियर है आपको? नाउ व्हाट इज गोइंग टू हैपन, ऑल दीज फेनोमेना व्हेन टेकिंग प्लेस एज अ रिजल्ट द नेगेटिव चार्ज गेट्स अक्युमुलेटेड इन द लोअर एजेस ऑफ क्लाउड्स व्हाइल द पॉजिटिव चार्जेस दे अक्युमुलेट ऑन द अपर एजेस। ओके सपोज दीज टू क्लाउड्स के बीच में सेपरेशन हो रहा है चार्जेस का, तो क्या होगा, जो पॉजिटिव चार्ज है वो कहां पे एक्युमुलेट होगा, अपर एज पे पॉजिटिव चार्ज यहां एक्युमुलेट होगा, नेगेटिव चार्ज लोअर एज पे एक्युमुलेट होंगे। ओके सो इसके बाद क्या होगा, पॉजिटिव चार्ज एक्युमुलेट्स on upper edge and negative charge on lower edge. Okay, positive charge कहाँ accumulate होंगे, upper edge पे, और negative charge accumulate होंगे lower edge पे। Fine. Now after this, what is going to happen? As I have told you, positive charge all over. We know that our earth, our ground is accumulated with positive charge all over. Fine. Next. So now what will happen? These charges, they will begin to multiply. Okay, these charges will begin to multiply due to increase in wind. High wind is blowing. You must have seen that when thunderstorm comes, there is a high wind, there is a rainfall also. So these charges, they will multiply. They will start increase. Okay, so charges will multiply. Okay, these charges, they are going to multiply. Now, although the air is a poor conductor of electricity, we know that air is a poor conductor of electricity. Okay, but due to this heavy charge, since charge have multiplied, बहुत सारे charge जब हो गए, charge multiply हो गए, बहुत सारे charge बन गए, तो अब ये जो heavy charge है, due to this heavy charge, it is unable to restrict the electric flow after some time. Okay? जो electric flow हो रहा है उसको ये restrict नहीं कर पाएगा उस समय के बाद. Okay? So although the air is a poor conductor of electricity, but due to heavy charges, it is unable to restrict the electric flow after some time. Fine? So the negative charges and the positive charges meet. They are the negative charge and the positive charge, they are going to meet, which results in the production of electric sparks. ठीक है? जब पॉजिटिव और नेगेटिव चार्ज जो है कि मीट करेंगे तो क्या होगा, उसी से इलेक्ट्रिक स्पार्क्स बनते हैं. ओके, सो दे आर इन द फॉर्म ऑफ द स्ट्रीक्स ऑफ लाइट एंड अलोंग विद द साउंड. ओके, सो चार्जेस विल मल्टीप्लाई एंड नाउ पॉजिटिव एंड नेगेटिव चार्ज विल meet. Okay, so the negative charge and the positive charge will meet, which results in the production of electric spark. Which results in electric spark. Okay, electric spark hoga. So basically, this was a flow, you can see. A flow of how a lightning or electric discharge takes place. So we can say that if we want to a definition, we can say that the process of flow of charge from cloud to cloud, or you can say from cloud to earth, fine, or from cloud to air, you can say. Due to the separation of positive and negative charge, they are separating. That is a electric discharge, or you can say that it is a electric story of a lightning. Okay. So the first step is that the hot air is going to move upward. Since the hot air moves upward, water droplets, they move downward. It will cause separation of charges. There will be a separation of charges between the clouds and also between the cloud and the earth. Then fourth is that positive charge accumulates on the upper edge and negative charge on the lower edge. Fifth is that charges will multiply. Since wind is blowing very high speed, sound is there, air is blowing, these charges, they get starts to multiply. And at the last, the positive and negative charge will meet, which results in electric spark. और उसी को हम क्या बोलते हैं, lightning या electric current हम बोलते हैं. Okay, so this was a flow, just go through it. This is a process, whole process, how lightning takes place. Meanwhile, if you have not subscribed our okay. So as I have told you, suppose this is one cloud. So distribution of charge is going to take place. So the positive charge will go up and the negatives are going to be on the lower edge. Fine. So the first lightning can take place. The first form of the lightning is between cloud to cloud. Cloud to cloud. Okay. So this is one cloud. Here I am making another cloud. Positive is on upper edge. Negative is on lower edge. Okay. So cloud to cloud lightning will take place. We know that lightning can occur like this. Okay. So this was a cloud to cloud lightning. The second type of lightning is cloud to air. ठीक है, cloud to air होगी एक lightning. इसमें क्या होगा? ये आपका cloud है. Positive upper edge पे है, negative lower edge पे है. अब ये जो sparkles होंगे, ये ऐसे air में रहेंगे. Okay? So this is cloud to air sparkle. And the third type is cloud to the ground lightning, or you can say earth. Okay? Cloud to earth. Cloud से lightning कहाँ पे आएगी? Earth पे आएगी. ये आपके big lightning है. Fine? So the upper edges are going to be positive, the lower are negative, so they are going to be down like this on the earth. Fine. Like this. So lightning can be like three types: the cloud to cloud, cloud to air, and cloud to earth. Negative and positive charge droplets are there, you can see here. Okay, so this was about the story of lightning, or you can say how electric discharge takes place, electric current discharge takes place. Okay, so I hope it will be very clear to you all. So we have seen all the story of lightning, how lightning takes place, and how it is being caused. Okay, so this lightning, it can be deadly sometimes. It can be very deadly and it can cause lots of destruction. Okay, so this destruction can be in the life of anybody. Anybody can die if the lightning is going to affect, or some properties like some building, some industry, some shops can be destroyed. Okay. So lightning is very harmful if it is going to harm any life or any property. ये जो lightning की जिसकी हमने बात की, हमने देखा कि lightning कैसे occur होता है, तो ये basically है तो बस एक electric spark, but ये electric spark बहुत large scale में है. इतने large scale में है कि ये किसी की life ले सकता है, कोई property destroy कर सकता है, अगर उसके ऊपर ये गिर जाए तो. So in ancient time, if we see that ancient time में जब lightning होती थी, तो what people used to think, उनका क्या thought था, उनकी क्या mentality थी? क्योंकि what happened in ancient time, there was no such development of science, so people were not aware of the story of lightning. They were not knowing कि actually why lightning takes place. So ancient time, people were very scared. Ancient time में लोग बहुत scared थे. Why were they scared? Because they think that lightning was some cause of a god, or some god has been angry, or कुछ भगवान की महिमा types they used to believe कि कुछ ऐसा है, भगवान angry हो गए हैं, और god is angry, so that's why he is showing such and such temper. Okay, so they were actually scared. Ancient peoples were scared of lightning. But nowadays, scientists have evolved some precautions also. How we can take precautions, how we can save our buildings when they are being built. That can help us to prepare ourselves and also to protect ourselves from this natural phenomenons. Okay? So, जैसे कि लोग ancient time में डरे रहते थे क्योंकि उनको पता नहीं था कि basically lightning की story क्या है, as I have just now told you. So, they thought it, they have taken it in some other way, some mythological way they have taken it. But nowadays इतना development हो गया research में, scientists ने पूरा prove कर दिया कि हाँ lightning क्यों होती है. And there is a defense mechanism also, how we can defend ourselves, how we can prepare to be safe from this lightning. Okay, so now I will be telling you how we can save ourselves from the lightning. Okay, so let's see the lightning safety.
Or any safe place you find yourself, and if you do not yourself, you can shelter under small tree. Just go under a small tree. Okay? So, find a safe shelter for yourself. Safe place to hide or you can say to shelter. Fine? The second thing what you can do is that if you are in some vehicle, in your car, in any bus or anything, then you should stay inside that. Just you have to close the windows and the door of your car and all. You have to shut them. Okay? So be inside any vehicle. Okay? Whichever vehicle you are. In cars, bus, anything which is covered, not on two wheelers, any vehicle that you can cover yourself. You can close the door and windows. Okay? The next very important thing is that at that time you must have seen that when lightning is there, you should never touch any metal poles. On the roads, you have seen that there are so many metal poles are there. So please don't touch them ever. Okay? So don't touch metal poles. Fine? You should never touch the metal poles. Next, what you have to do is that you should not lie on the ground. Do not lie on the ground. Instead, what you can do, you can bend your head between your hands. Okay? So do not lie on a ground. Don't lie down on a ground. Okay, so lightning safety, there can be two cases. If you are outside your house, if you are inside your house. If you are outside your house, the safety you can take place is firstly find a shelter for yourself, a safe place. If you are in any vehicle like your car and all, just be inside. Don't touch any metal poles, any metal wire, anything. And don't lie down on a ground. If you are outside, inside your house, unplug all electrical appliances. At that time, please do not take bath. And just avoid to come in contact with electric wires and telephone, etc. Okay? So this was how we can save ourselves if lightning takes place. Okay? Next, I will be telling you that our device that is a lightning conductor is being developed, which is nowadays fitted in all our buildings just to save our buildings, our apartment from lightning. Okay? So next we will discuss about lightning conductors.
Lightning.
Okay, so lightning. it. So lightning conductor consists of a metal rod. A metal rod is there, which is taller than the building. Okay. Suppose this is a building. अगर ये बिल्डिंग है तो जो लाइटनिंग कंडक्टर का मेटल रॉड होगा वो क्या होगा, इतना बड़ा होगा. मीन्स ये मेटल रॉड जो है ये बिल्डिंग से थोड़ा सा बड़ा होगा. लाइटनिंग कंडक्टर में एक मेटल रॉड होता है जो कि क्या होगा, बिल्डिंग से हमेशा टॉलर होगा. ओके, अगर ये बिल्डिंग है तो ये मेटल रॉड है विच इज बीइंग टॉलर फ्रॉम द बिल्डिंग. ओके, द नेक्स्ट थिंग अबाउट लाइटनिंग कंडक्टर इज दैट व्हाट हैपेंस कि दिस पोर्शन व्हिच इज अबव द बिल्डिंग यू कैन सी, सो द लिटिल पोर्शन ऑफ दिस मेटल रॉड रिमेन्स इन अ एयर. ओके, ऑन द टॉप ऑफ अ बिल्डिंग, बिल्डिंग के टॉप पे ही रहेगा ऐसे, और ये थोड़ा बिल्डिंग के ऊपर, और जो उसका अदर एंड है इस मेटल रॉड का वो कहां चला जाएगा, द अदर एंड ऑफ मेटल रॉड इज कनेक्टेड विद अ कॉपर प्लेट. एक कॉपर प्लेट से कनेक्टेड होगा अदर एंड. ओके, और ये डीप इन द सॉइल, अर्थ में या सॉइल में रहेगा, अर्थ के अंदर सॉइल में रहेगा. तो बेसिकली लाइटनिंग कंडक्टर में एक मेटल रॉड होती है जो कि जिस भी बिल्डिंग में लगाना है उसके लेंथ से हमेशा बड़ी होती है. उसका ऊपर का थोड़ा सा पोर्शन एयर में रहेगा, जो नीचे का एंड है वो किससे अटैच होगा, वो सॉइल में अटैच होगा. ओके, सो जनरली क्या किया जाता है कि दिस सेटअप इज बीइंग इंस्टॉल्ड विद इन द बिल्डिंग ड्यूरिंग द कंस्ट्रक्शन ऑफ अ बिल्डिंग. जब बिल्डिंग का कंस्ट्रक्शन होता है तो विद इन द वॉल्स दिस सेटअप इज बीइंग installed at that time. Okay, so this rod, it acts as a, this metal rod acts as a passage for electric discharge. This will act as a passage for electric discharge. I have taught you about electric discharge. We have seen that how the lightning, the effect of electric, it goes into the earth. Okay, so during lightning kya hoga, jo electric current hogi वो सॉइल में अर्थ के अंदर आ जाएगी विदाउट हार्मिंग द बिल्डिंग. इट इज नॉट गोइंग टू हार्म द बिल्डिंग एंड इट विल द इलेक्ट्रिक करंट विल गो इनसाइड द अर्थ. ओके, सो दिस वाज अबाउट लाइटनिंग कंडक्टर. 3-4 मेन पॉइंट्स आर देयर अबाउट लाइटनिंग कंडक्टर. द फर्स्ट पॉइंट अबाउट लाइटनिंग कंडक्टर इज दैट इट हैज गॉट मेटल रॉड टॉलर दैन द बिल्डिंग. ओके, सेकेंड थिंग क्या है कि इसका एक एंड इट्स वन एंड इज इन द एयर अबव द बिल्डिंग. ओके, एक एंड तो एयर में है बिल्डिंग के अंदर, दूसरा एंड क्या होगा, अदर साइड इज कनेक्टेड टू ग्राउंड और यू कैन से सॉइल. ओके, तो दिस मेटल रॉड helps in easy discharge of electric current into the ground. Ground में electric current का easy discharge हो जाएगा without harming the building. Okay, so metal conductor. Lightning conductor is a device that helps us to protect our building during lightning. It has got a metal rod that is taller than the building. The one of the metal rod is above the building in a layer. The other end of a metal rod is inside the soil or ground. Metal rod kya help karta hai? It helps us in an easy discharge of electric current. Electric current ka discharge ho jayega ground mein, jiski wajah se building pe koi harm nahi hoga. Okay? So this was about lightning conductors. Nowadays scientists have developed, researchers have developed lightning conductors, which is very helpful, which can protect us, our building, from getting harm from the lightning. Okay? So we have discussed our natural calamity, that is our lightning in part 3. In the part 4, we are going to discuss on earthquake. Okay, so this was all for today. Thank you so much. Thank you for watching my video. If you like it, please give a like button. And if you have not subscribed on the channel, Wally Scholar yet, please do subscribe it so that you will be the first one to get the updates, to get the notification whenever we update any video. Okay, so thank you so much. Thank you for watching my video.